Hello. As you may recall, last time we found a linear transformation which reflected a vector in R2 about the line y is equal to negative x. Well, today I want to talk about eigenvalues and eigenvectors, and I want to give you an intuitive approach here, so this might be a shorter video, and then we will look at the theory later. I thought that the example we did last time was a perfect example of an intuitive example. So last time we looked at these two vectors because we know what the transformation would do to those. We looked at the vector that was on the line, the 1, negative 1, because we knew that that would just stay there if it reflected about that line. And then we looked at the vector 1, 1, which was normal to that line. We knew that that would reflect it exactly the opposite way. So this is a good tie-in for eigenvalues and eigenvectors. So really, what are eigenvalues and eigenvectors? Essentially, eigenvalues and eigenvectors look like this. When you have a matrix A, which we found, so this is the matrix A for that reflection about the line y is equal to x. If you take A times a certain vector, and you get a scalar multiple of that vector back, then we call V an eigenvector for A. And lambda is a corresponding eigenvalue for A. So essentially what it means, if you look at the transformation, what it means is if I plug a vector into that transformation, multiply it by that matrix A, I should get a multiple of that vector back. Or if I'm just looking at the eigenvalues and vectors of a matrix, what it says is if I multiply that matrix times a vector, I should just get a scalar multiple of it back. So it really scales these. So the number of these eigenvalues is equal to the dimension of the matrix. So in this case above, we should have two eigenvalues. So I claim that if we sort of look up top here, that those eigenvalues should be exactly corresponding to those eigenvectors that we're using up here, the one in purple and the one in red. So let's take a look at that and why that might be the case. If I look at this vector in the direction of that line, 1, negative 1, what does the matrix do to it? If I take A times this vector V, I get zero, negative one, negative one, zero times one, negative one, and that's equal to, multiply across and down, that's one. Multiply across and down, that's negative 1. So it's equal to the exact same vector here. So I've got A, V is equal to 1, that's my eigenvalue, times my vector V. And we knew that because it just stays there. And if I look at this normal vector, which was 1, 1, we should see the transformation is just going to be the opposite. So T of n should equal negative 1, negative 1. So you can almost guess what the eigenvalue will be that corresponds to that. Can you guess? Well, you're right. It's going to be negative 1. So if I take A times n, the normal vector, I get 0, negative 1, negative 1, 0, times that normal vector, 1, 1, and that will give me this times this, negative 1, this times that, negative 1, which is equal to a negative 1 times the original vector I plugged in. So you can see that in this case, A times n is equal to negative 1 times n. So these two values here are eigenvalues. They scale them. So if we were looking for the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of this one, the eigenvalues would be